Welcome back to Let's Play Vampires the Masquerade Bloodlines. Here in our cozy little apartment just over Trip's pawn shop with our lovely ghoul bitch called Hazla. Is it Hazla? Yeah, yeah. Yeah. So last episode we helped out our big chubby friend Larry to get back some suitcase from some weirdos. And we're now heading, because we were distracted by that guy, to Grout's mansion, the Malkavian Primogen, to solve some problems once again. Okay, so we now need a taxi, which is on the other side. We don't need any blood, all good. We just got pumped up with some money. Yeah, I think it's all good. It's gonna be a fun night, huh? What are you looking at? What are you looking at? Just... taxi, there you are. I'm gonna jump over you. No, I don't.
Where to?
Away from here. Grout's mansion. There you go. Oi. Oh. Hello, Mr. Rodriguez.
You. What are you doing here?
Yo, Nines, what's up?
No.
Are you looking into Grout's disappearance too?
You should get out of here. This place is bad news. Pardon me.
You hear that echo? Weird. Why? What's inside? Huh! Well, that's odd. What's he doing in here? Well. Okay. Let's just. Pretend we never saw our anarch friend in there. Oop! Combat zone, okay. Oh, yeah, we should keep in mind that we're now on Malkavian territory, so this is gonna be one crazy night. Don't you think? Don't you think? What you doing with your knife? And your little mask? Huh? Hello! Hi. Oi! Fuck you! Okay. Okay. Wait. Perch. Yes. Fuck you, all of you. Very, very cool. Let me just a second. There you go. It's a nice building. Huh. Huh. Looks like me last night. Okay. Where to? Let's go that way. Okay. So, having fun there, huh? Can we sneak up and, like, finish him? We sure can. BAM! Fuck you! Ooh. Circus performer. It's a skill book. Okay, read. Stats increased. Which one? What was he? There's a note. Perception at once shapes the mind and rules over time. Time, however, orders human perception and then in turn warps the mind. The mind is capricious, having various effects on perception, time, and the mind itself. If harmony, progress is made. Yes. Okay, so this seems like a riddle. We have time, mind, and this might be perception. But what are those?
Another unfortunate casualty to Tide of Time, insane asylums. I lament their loss not only as brokerage houses for the breadth and depth of human psychosis, but also I shall mourn the disappearance of that peculiar environment present only in an insane asylum. That palpable atmosphere of blistered brains and churning bowels, the odoriferous mélange of freely flowing bodily humors, that gently rolling cacophony of distant sobs and screams, the muttered cursing at perceived enemies, and the blissful gurgling of the lobotomized, like a newborn babe discovering the sky. I shall still find test subjects as surely as I find bloody sustenance in the night, but this climate, I fear, may never be replicated.
Okay, so there's another one. What?
Okay. It is quite peculiar, the happenings I've been made to witness for my supernatural longevity. I am thinking of one unfortunate phenomenon in particular, of unique interest to my station, both as a professional and as a sufferer of this vampiric condition. It seems the stream of time has begun to erode the moorings of my chosen course of study, for the methodologies that gave birth to psychology are slowly disappearing. I find myself in an era that overlooks the physical component of psychological pathology time and again in favor of the sophistic practices of Freud. Phrenology, dactopintalism, and the rest of the old guard has fallen by the wayside, its champions all silenced in death, with my unique exception. Would that I could make my voice heard again, although it may be suspicious should I return to popular medical discourse 50 years after my apparent death. No, better that I continue my studies into the psychoses in secret. One day, may I hold up my own cure as validation of the methods. I am
my
confident
cure.
No cure for my condition, more than if my beloved wife lies within our figurative minds, waiting to be unlocked by the correct combination of memories recovered from our childhood. And I'm most certain it has nothing to do with the relationship between myself and my parents and my in time, too, may your star fade and disappear.
Please excuse that I was a bit in a hurry there. But we solved the riddle. Really cautious about those. Okay, so why don't they attack us? They hate us. Why don't you attack me? If I don't attack you, what you gonna do about it? I just don't attack you now. Good. Okay, locked. Locked. Oh, she's getting ready. So this might be locked too, okay. Now she's coming, see that? What? Well, okay then, so no bad feelings when we whoop their asses before they attack us, so let's just get rid of all those crazy fuckers. Damn! Come on! Thank you. Blubba! Bam! Yeah, that's right. That's... God damn it. Controls are really weird tonight. That's what she said. Okay, so there is a room. Is there anything?
Often I reflect with great regret on the missed opportunity that was my infector. Had I been conscious after the attack, I could have stopped the orderlies from locking her in the roaming pen. What I would give for just one interview, a few simple questions of the plague-ridden woman who met her end that dawn. Of course, there was no guarantee she would have been any more helpful than my current crop of test subjects, mewling wretches. Few could be called enthusiastic. Given the nature of the tests, I cannot expect the same fervor from all, but a modicum of cooperation would be appreciated. Animals. The one called John went so far as to gnaw off his arm and escape into the floorboards like some feral rodent. I still hear him scurrying about at night. It must be an atrocious mess.
What kind of weird experiments are you doing here? Where's my microphone? There it is. Who's the... Oh, hello.
My studies proceed at a languid pace. I'm mired in a foul ennui as my wife's illness advances. My subjects grow restless without proper supervision, but I cannot pull myself back. How many nights I've wasted now, gazing from the tower walk, pondering the frailty of existence.
What? Okay. So let's walk up here. Ah, nice. Nice view. You're kinda nice. Is this the tower of Mr. LaCroix? LaCroix? Maybe. So let's go down here. Graphics are flickering. Oy, 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 like in true Malkavian style. Everything is turning weird. I'm gonna suck on that hoe. What? What? Dude. Thank you. Okay. Open. And here we go. Hell yeah, hell yeah. That's good. Fuck you. All of you. Fuck. Yes. Ah. Bloodshot! Come on. One more. One more. There you go. Okay, then. That way? No. We were here already. What? Yeah. That was the one with the riddle. We came from here, I suppose. So it's let's take. Was there a naked? Okay. Open for business. Okay. Ah, that's really clever. See that? That's not a mirror.
After decades of solitary study into this affliction, I have learned that it is by no means mine alone. Indeed, the city is home to an entire society of similarly afflicted individuals with whom I've only recently made contact. They are an understandably standoffish sort by and large, but I have been able to confirm with them that the condition is indeed vampirism, which apparently comes in a multitude of strains, each with a spectacular set of symptoms such as invisibility and even a sort of lycanthropy. Through numerous official interactions with the governing body of this secret society, I have concluded that their fundamental understanding of the vampiric condition is woefully lacking, and mired in suspicion and pseudo-religious dogma that would make a Turk balk for its scratches. Indeed, they seemed impressed with my studies and the eloquence with which I was able to present them. Apparently, the typical sufferer of my particular strain of vampirism is far from the vanguard of the King's English. So impressed were they that they even offered me an office in their government, a rather high office by the sound of things, I believe I shall accept. If nothing else, it should provide a lofty vantage point from which to observe the breadth and epidemiology of the affliction so that I may move more expeditiously toward a cure.
Okay, where to? Huh. Or do we have to revisit one of the older rooms? Well, not that one. No. No. This one's closed. Okay. Ah. What? Oh, there you go. No? Okay. Huh. Odd. Odd. Does this trigger something in here? Maybe? No, this is just the way up here. Hmm. Okay, so we came in here. This one's closed. This there leads to this office thingy. And this leads to here. So this means this room here. Yes, exactly. Okay, is it really the same? Which it's not logical. This is not the same room, is it? Well, yeah, it is, but let me just Yeah, it is. Yeah, we did stuff there. Okay, okay. Hmm. Those little Malkavians. I have to push this button to get up here. Okay. Every time I hit the button, the controls fade away. Uh-huh. I don't know why I just did that, but I did it. Yeah. This is all not new. What did I miss? What did I miss? So we're here again. Did I miss something in here? No, I don't think so. So we're just right on the other side of this building, so we for sure have missed something. Like in the early state. Why is this door closed? With this trigger, I just open up this door. Mm-hmm. Okay. This one leads to the front entrance where the level started. Yeah, this is like going out and shit. So we don't want that. Did we miss something in here? No, we solved that riddle already. But maybe there are. No, we did that. We did that good. Well, it doesn't do shit, does it? Yeah, no need, because we already opened that door. Is there a ladder? Ah! Let's check that out. It leads to nowhere. Okay then. I really don't know. We missed something for sure. Oh, sorry. Where's the third person key? There it is. Okay, This door... Now it's locked, because we fucked up the riddle. Yeah. Now everything's closed now. Fucking shit. What's going on in this room? We surely missed something in here, because there were just bad guys and nothing else. There may be something here in this... Ah! There you go! Told you this isn't a freaking mirror. Come on. And... Ah. Ah! You're a naughty boy. Kim, come on! I'm gonna shoot you. I'm gonna shoot you. While you fucking... Yeah, give me back that shit, yes. That's right, bitch. Okay, so... We weren't fooled by this game. Well, we were, but... Well, I was, but yeah. So, now we're up here. This is the thingy. We just smacked our head on it. And there's stuff going on here. Oh, more riddles. Dude, okay, let's just listen to that and read that other shit and try to figure out what's going on.
I have accepted the role of Primogen for Clan Malkavian, the dreadfully winsome label applied to the particular strain of vampirism I suffer, so named for some supposed vampire father figure of old. More poppycock grown from a backward culture that seems interminably drawn to children's tales and the fiction of Victorian romance when it should concern itself with the science behind their suffering. No matter, for I have taken this office for no greater reason.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
My research. I must make mention, however, that
fuck
even with my would-be peers in this governing body of vampires, the level of paranoia and superstition is frightening. Their intelligence is not the question, oh, indeed. As they courted me for this appointment, I had to suspect that their overtures were hand-tailored to what must be my obvious infatuation with reason, for the devil would do well to have such honey-tongued tempters. Even so, I could not help but notice the dressing of language these vampire leaders chose.
Stop looking at me.
Silent song.
Thank you.
Whether it is born of habit, from addressing their unwashed, ill-educated subjects, or from their own deep-seated beliefs, their linguistic flourishes belie a faith in superstition over the providence of empirical reason that must be an all-pervasive theme in this society of darkest night. Damn it all, now I'm doing it too.
Oh, dear Lord. Okay. Ooh. Oi. Let me switch the view. Oi. Well. I'll just quickly save. Just in case. And, Frenzy check modifier open. More of those? Yeah. Do we have to push all those thingies? Ah! Okay. So, no. Okay, so let's try that again. We have to go there. How? Fuck. Maybe. Well, not really. Huh. How? Ah! God damn it! Where's the stupid key? There it is! Okay, another switch. And this door is open now. Thank you. Do I have to go this way? That way? Whatever. Yes, I think so. Yeah. Somewhere here. This door. And what next? Can we go here? Should I bother trying? Come on. Well. Wait. Oh. You dead? Yeah. So this is where you're making your weird experimental stuff. Oy, oy, oy. Okay then, so what's in here? Can we read that? No. No, we can't do that shit. Freezer. Can I make it? Any blood buff? Let's try it again with some buff. Success. What's inside? Ah, blood pack. Cool, thank you. Well, actually, we don't really need it right now because we can replenish some blood points with this blood strike, which is really handy. Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for not kicking me in the nuts. And, well, you too. And you too. Thank you. Okay. No. No. Yes. Yeah, he's gonna hit me. Well then. When you have blood buff on, it's so freaking powerful. It's just is this the right way? Yeah, I'm sure it is. Yeah. Ah! A secret door. Can't see shit. I just walk. Where the fuck are we? Eh? Dude. Why am I blinking? Huh? Where the fuck am I? I'm back where I came from. Sort of. Huh? Stop confusing me! Oh, shotgun ammo and some other ammo. Cool, cool. No, that's wrong. God damn it. Okay, so from now on, I won't get distracted by any of those fancy stairways or whatever. I just follow the road as I'm supposed to do. Hey, fuck you. Don't interrupt me ever again. Please. You dead? No. But yes, you are. Okay, so we are okay. Haven't been here so far. Nothing going on here. I suppose. Ah, yes, there you go. Another jumping part. I really like that, and I'm really good at it. There you go. Let's just. Oh, what? No blood? You know what? What's something?
The voices have increased in frequency and direction. They have begun to stay with me long after conversation has ceased and are serving as quite a distraction. I fear others are beginning to notice my preoccupation at the vampire gatherings. I am thinking again of the particular vampire of whom I spoke previously, who I dare not name for my growing fear. If the voices are to be believed, then my caution is warranted, for they speak of his blackest crimes, both past and future. More than once, I have seen the suspicion in his eyes and heard the distrust in his voice when speaking of me. The fear must register on my face, as it is all I can do in these moments to keep from crying out in chorus with the voices.
They are so weird. You're all weird. Just look at me. I do magic and shit. I am not weird at all.
I am no longer sick. I know it. The voices have proven themselves authentic, and I have withdrawn from the vampire society entirely.
Oi, okay.
My absence will no doubt draw attention, but I could no longer hold my fragile composure around the ravenous eyes of my vampire peers, especially not around him. The voices compelled me to make what I fear is a Faustian bargain.
A Faustian bargain?
For their demands are constant and merciless. I have secluded myself within the mansion. I know he will strike out at me. He will go to any length to achieve his ambitions, and he knows that I know. I have taken precautions to protect my beloved wife. The cure will have to wait until our immediate safety is guaranteed. The mansion was constructed with security in mind, but at that time I was not privy to the full range of vampire capabilities. The voices echo in the twisted corridors of my psyche. Dark whisperings of a macabre and formless menace, the approach of which portends an end to all of this.
So it disappeared, voices, and I am pretty sure he distrusts Mr. LaCroix. Well, can. So that's your beloved. There. Gone. Hello. Oh, hello. Would you look at that? Okay, that's a weird. graphics thingy. I think there should be something going on in there. Ah, yes. This is not good. Nope, this is not good at all. Oh shit. Sir? Hello? No? Okay. What's going on? Ah, oh, fire!
By the flames!
The fuck is you? I'm not Grout. Here I am. Who the hell are you?
How is that? Pity you could not be by my hand. No matter. Soon your self-made kings and false prophets and all who bear the mark of the beast will be washed from the earth for
come
the coming of the Lord.
Coming of the Lord. What are those, vampire hunters? Who the hell are you?
As you burn, tell them it was Grünfeld
Bach
who sent your damned soul to that lake of fire. All agents of Satan shall return to whence they came.
Oh shit. Oh shit. I think I'm gonna leave. No. Let me just quickly make another save somewhere. Cause I'm pretty sure I'm gonna die. Who the fuck are you? Ah! But you realize that we're now on the same side and shit, see that, huh? Well... What? Fucking hell. Okay, is there an earlier state of... Yeah, let's take this autosave. Autosave. Gonna skip that. Can I skip that? We just saw that. Fuck. I'm sorry. Okay, so we triggered the explosion. Talk to that douche.
How is that?
Down the same shit.
Yes, you burn.
Good. Let's take. Just yeah, that's good. What we can use, just in case, blood shield. Yeah. Pretty much. Ah! No. Bad idea. Yeah. We're gonna stop. Thank you. This was close before, was it? Pretty sure it was close before. I'm pretty sure it was closed before. Maybe Grünfeld Bach just opened it.
Hey, stop right there.
Did you just say freeze to me? Huh. I think I'm gonna go. I'm out of here, bitches. Yeah, I'm still. What? Still burning. Who cares? I'm burning. And I just jump out of the window. Fuck all of you. Okay. Badass. And, yep. That was. What's that? Is So Grout's dead, and there's clearly a badass German vampire hunter messing with shit and stuff. Oh, we're already back here. Well, yeah, let's just quickly finish the quest and see what Dooster McGee has to tell us. Hey there, Chunk!
Evening there! Something burning? Ooh, smells like someone burnt the burgers.
Yeah, I don't smell anything. I've got an appointment with LaCroix.
Sure, I'll open her up for you.
He's a fun guy.
Jeez, I could go for one of them double space burgers. The onions, the cheese, the bacon.
Yeah, I hear you. Okay.
The Primogens still haven't been contacted by Grout. I thought I made it clear that you are not supposed to come back until we had heard from him.
Grout's dead.
Grout's dead? What?
Yeah, and this guy, Bach, set his house on fire, nearly killed me. Second almost died of my friends, we just got sad. Who's Bach? He tried to burn me up. He really hates you. Let's go with number three.
Bach!
Bach!
Every time I think he's lost the scent. So, Bach killed Grout to draw me out.
Seemed like Grout was already dead when he arrived.
Bach is a hunter. They stalk and kill our kind to appease their god. But like many mortals, their so-called faith is nothing but a conduit through which they quench their killing urge. Who else would have killed Grout?
Uh-oh. I don't want to be a telltale. If you'd let me finish.
Let you finish? With whom do you presume you're speaking?
I was just going to add, I saw Nines there.
Look at me. Are you sure it was Nines Rodriguez?
Oh shit.
Because if it was, the consequences. Do you know where this might lead? Do you really have any idea?
I'm positive it was Nine. This may mean war with the Anarchists, right? Why don't you tell me, Captain Dramatic? I want to say that.
I'm glad you find this so amusing.
Captain Dramatic.
I don't. And do you know why?
It means why? Don't say that.
Under most circumstances, I would call a blood hunt on the murderer immediately. However, the Anarchs of this city may interpret such an action to be a declaration of war. I do not want a war with them. This decision will take some time. I need to confer with the Primogen on this. In the meantime, I've come to a decision on the Ankaran sarcophagus, and I believe that for the safety of the inhabitants of this city, we need to place the sarcophagus under Camarilla protection until its contents can be confirmed. You're becoming quite indispensable to me. So, out of all my available personnel, I'm going to entrust the retrieval of the sarcophagus to you.
Yeah, yeah.
It was quietly delivered to the Museum of Natural History a few hours ago.
Yeah, yeah. But I just got...
Let me finish. Oh. The manifest from the Dane shows there was a small box from the same dig on board, but it was listed as missing. Keep an eye open for it. It may have been overlooked. It's crucial we get the sarcophagus in our possession within the next few hours.
You didn't tell me what to do. Well... I want to say number three, but he's gonna get pissy, but I don't care, Mr. Captain Dramatic. I don't even know why I went to see Grout. I'm through running your errands. No, I want to say... Well, yes, fuck that.
I have methodically calculated a solution to each dilemma thrust upon our community.
See that?
And I don't have the time to paint your tiny mind its place in the big picture for each and every instance. So either serve your function, or get out of my sight.
Let's play along. Fine. What do I have to do?
Here are the keys to the front door of the museum.
What do I have to do?
The sarcophagus should be in an examination room of some sort. There's a small security staff on site, but I don't want a massacre. Mortals are just as easy to deceive as they are to kill.
Yeah, yeah. No, I don't have any more questions for you, because you're a
douche. There is a degree of immediacy attached to this task. Work fast. And, as on the Dane, you are not to open the Ankaran sarcophagus for any reason.
See that?
Excuse me.
See that? Oh fuck. We're stuck. We're fucking stuck. Oh shit. Ah! Okay, so, And we finished the quest. Let me figure out how to get this, but I will do that off screen. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye!